वेलकम टू हेल्प फॉर गुड लर्निंग। आई एम आशीष गढ़पाले, जावा ट्रेनर। टुडे वी हैव मिस्टर प्रशांत झा, हु इज पाइथन ट्रेनर। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टेक्निकल इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चन आंसर इन पाइथन। आफ्टर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो, इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन, यू कैन ड्रॉप योर क्वेश्चन इन कमेंट बॉक्स, वी विल डेफिनेटली रिप्लाई यू। यस प्रशांत, टेल मी हाउ पाइथन इज सिंपल एंड ईजी लैंग्वेज।
Yeah, Python are very simple and easy language. For example, I have to print a very simple statement, hello world. So in case of Java, I have to write at least 5 to 6 line of code, like class name, public static void main, and we have to maintain all the syntactical structure. And inside of that, system.out.println hello world. So we can see that in case of Java, I have to write a 5 to 6 line of code for just printing a one line statement, hello world. Similarly, in C and C++, we have to write a 4 to 5 line of code. We have to include the library, then void main function, then inside of void main function, we have to write a printf function, and inside of printf function, I have to write hello world. So basically, as we can see in Java, as well as in C and C++, we have to write minimum 5 to 6 line of code for getting just one line output, hello world. But in case of Python, as we know that we have to write only one line statement and one line code, that is a print. Inside of print, I have to write a hello world. So basically we will get the output, and that's why we can say that Python is very simple, because on the basis of syntactical structure, we can predict that exactly how much code we have to write, and Python provides us to write a customized code capability.
What are the applications of Python, and what type of application we can develop using Python?
There are different types of applications we can develop by using a Python. That means by using a Python, we can develop a desktop-based application, game application, AI-based application, web-based application, database application, network-based applications, so IoT-based application. These are the various category. That means by using a Python, if you know the Python, then we can develop this kind of application. And obviously, if we want to go for a web development, then we have to use some framework like a Django, Flask. If you want to develop AI-based application, then we have to use a customized version of Python, that is your Anaconda. So as per the particular category, we have to just modify, we have to just choose something. So we can develop by using a Python, we can develop a different types of applications.
What are the flavors of Python, Prashant?
Flavors of Python is a customized version of Python, and as we know that Python is a freeware and open source. Freeware in the sense we don't have to pay any licensing fees, and open source is basically Python source code is open. So suppose we have some standard and specific requirement, and standard Python is not going to fulfill our requirement. So what we can do, we can customize the Python. Okay, like if you want to work with the C language, we have a customized version of Python, that is C Python. If you want to work with a Java language, we have a customized version of Python, that is JPython. Similarly, for .NET we have a Iron Python, for a Ruby we have a Ruby Python, for data science machine learning we have a very specialized customized version of Python, that is Anaconda Python.
Great. What is mean by identifiers?
Identifier is a name, like a name of variable, function, class, object, which we provide in a Python, that is called the identifier. And there are some rules to define identifier, like we cannot start any identifier name with a digit allowed, but first letter must be a character. Then we cannot put a space between an identifier. That means if we take an identifier, like if I want to take a variable name Prashant space Jha, so what it will do, Python interpreter will treat as a two independent variable, and obviously Python interpreter does not found any comma separator operator, so obviously it will raise an error at the compile time. It will raise an error. So there are various rules, like we cannot use a reserved keywords as an identifier name.
Okay, what do you mean by data types?
Data type tells that which type of value hold by a variable, and in Python there is no need to define any data type externally or explicitly, because what happen exactly when we provide a value at the compile time or at the runtime. So as per that value, suppose we are providing a equal to 10. So as per that value, internally Python interpreter, that means Python virtual machine, will see that which type of value are coming. If the value is coming as an integer format, then automatically it will assign an integer class. If the value is coming in a float format, then automatically it will assign a float class.
Can you please explain the fundamental data types in Python?
There are five fundamental data types: int, float, complex, boolean, string. And all fundamental data types are immutable. Immutable in the sense, let's take an example. If I have to provide a equal to 10, then what will happen? Internally, Python virtual machine, obviously, first of all, it will check that the value, in which format the value is coming. The value is coming in integer format, then obviously it will assign automatically integer class. Now the second thing is that Python interpreter will check that is there any memory are available with the same value. If it is, obviously if it doesn't have, then it will create a new memory and it will put a 10 inside of that memory and will assign the reference of this memory to A. Similarly, when next time I will take a next variable B equal to 10, this time also same process will happen and Python virtual machine again will check that is there any memory are available with the same value with the same object. Yes, already A is having a 10 as a value in that memory. So what it will do, it will not create a new memory, it will assign the same memory reference to a B, that means to a new object, new variable. So this is called the immutability concept.
Great. Explain typecasting in Python.
Typecasting is conversion from one data type to another data type is called as a typecasting, and there are two types of typecasting. One is a implicit typecasting and another one is a explicit typecasting. So implicit typecasting is basically the conversion does by compiler or interpreter itself is called as a implicit typecasting, and those conversion which we do forcefully, that's are called as a explicit typecasting.
Prashant, can we convert complex value into integer?
No. Actually, complex value not possible to convert in int.
Prashant, which type of value we can typecast in Boolean?
Except 0, false and empty string, we can typecast anything else in Boolean.
Okay. How many reserved keywords are there in Python?
There are total 33 reserved keywords in Python, and true, false, none, except these three keywords all are in a lower case.
Prashant, when we will use list data type?
It is depend on our requirement, and as per our requirement we can use a list. Like in list we can store a data order wise, one by one location, like index number 0, 1, 2, 3 in this manner. Then heterogeneous data are possible, that means this similar type of data we can store, like integer, float, string, boolean, this type of data we can store. By nature list is a growable, so that as soon as we enter a data, as soon as we store a object inside a list, its size is automatically grows. As soon as we remove a data from a list, its size is automatically reduced. By nature, it is a growable. Also, and by using a square bracket, we represent a list and it is a mandatory. And one more important thing, that list is a mutable. So if you have stored an object and in future you want to change that, so you can change that object. That means list is a mutable. So if we have a this kind of requirements, obviously we can use a list data type.
Great. What is the difference between append and insert method?
Both the function used to add an object inside a list, but append function, by using append function we add a data at the end of the list, and by using an insert function we can specify the position, that means we can specify the index number. Suppose for example I want to insert a object in index number 3, so by using an insert function we can insert a particular object at that particular index number. In insert function we have to pass a two argument, first argument as an index number and second argument as a object, that means what we want to add inside of list. And append function is also used to represent a stack. Suppose we want to represent a stack in Python, so append function, by using an append function we can add that object inside a list also, because it add the object at the end of the list.
Okay, what is the difference between list and tuple?
List and tuple both are a collection data type. So by using a square bracket we represent a list and it is a mandatory. By using a circle bracket we represent a tuple and it is not a mandatory. If we don't have a fixed requirement, then obviously we should go with the list data type. If we have a fixed requirement, then we have to go with tuple data type. List is mutable, that means once we have entered any object so we can change that, but tuple is a immutable, that means non-changeable. And list object, we cannot take a list object as a key for a dictionary data type, but tuple object we can take as a key for a dictionary data type.
What is the use of dictionary data type in Python?
By using a dictionary data type we represent a data in key and value pair, and in real world also data is maintained by a key and value pair. Like in case of a student, as we know that in a single classroom maybe a same name of multiple students can available. So like there are two Prashant are available, so how can we identify that both are a different students by their roll number? Same happen with the employee. In case of employee, like there is an employee ID for an employee name, Like we, if we order something from any e-commerce site, so we get a order ID. Order ID is a key and order name is a value. So here we can see that key is always unique. That means roll number, employee ID, then order ID is always unique. But the value, that means the product name, the employee name, student name, it may be possible the duplicate name also available. So in this way we maintain a data. Similarly, this dictionary support us to store a data in this format also, like a key and value pair.
Okay, Prashant, how we can do address comparison in Python?
By using identity operator, we can do address comparison. There are two types of identity operator are there, is and is not. So let's take an example. If I have a equal to 10, as we know that Python virtual machine first check that is there any object or is there any memory are available with the same value. Obviously doesn't have, so it will create a new memory. Same next time b equal to 10, I have taken new value, new variable as a new value. But right now what will happen, again Python virtual machine will check that is there any memory are available with the same value. Yes, already a is a object which having a same value 10. So what will happen, Python virtual machine is going to assign the same memory reference to b. Now in this scenario, as we can see that a and b both are pointing to a same memory address, both are pointing to a same memory address. So by using identity operator, like if I check in this way, like inside of print a is b, so it will return a true. Why? Because both having a same address.
Great. What is membership operator in Python?
By using a membership operator, we check that the given object is available inside of collection data structure or string or not. So in and not in, there are two types of membership operator, in and not in. Like I want to check there, like I have, for example, I have a one list and inside of the list we have a number of students name. So I want to check that Prashant is a name of student which is available inside of list or not. So by using a in operator we can check that. So this membership operator help us to check this object is available inside a collection data structure or not, and it is very easy. Suppose if this operator will does not have in, if it is not available inside of Python, so obviously we have to go with the loop and if else statement.
What is constant?
There is no constant concept in Python.
What are the special operators?
There are two types of special operator in Python. One is an identity operator, another one is a membership operator. So in identity operator is a two types, is and is not. Membership operator is also two types, in and not in.
Prashant, how we can read dynamic input from the keyboard?
By using an input function, we can take a value from a keyboard, but in Python 3. In Python 2, there were two functions were there for taking a value from a user side. One is a raw input function and another one is an input function. But in raw input function, what was happening exactly, whatever the value you are taking, if you are taking a value in integer, if you are taking a value in float, but it takes a value as a string. So further, you have to typecast that value in your particular format. Like you want a data in integer, but as we know that raw input function will take a value as a string. So we have to typecast in our integer format. If we are taking a value float, so again, float value will take as a string. So we need to typecast it into a floating point format. But in Python 3, there is no raw input function. In Python 3, there is only one function, that is the input function. But in Python 3 also, input function by default taking a value, all the value it will take as a string. So again, whatever the format you want, you have to typecast in that particular function. So a particular format. So we have a respective function. For example, you want to typecast in a integer format, so we have an int function. If you want to typecast in format in floater format, so we have a float functions. So there is only one method in Python 3, that is the input functions. And by using an input functions, we can take a value from a keyboard.
Question: what are control statements?
There are three categories inside a control statement. First one is a conditional statement, second one is a transfer statement, and third one is a looping statement. In conditional statement, we have a simple if else, nested if else, else if ladder. In transfer statement, we have a break, continue, pass. And in looping statement, we have only two looping statement, for loop and while loop.
Question: can you please explain what is nested loop in Python?
A loop inside of another loop is called as a nested for loop. So outer loop is used for row and inner loop is used for column. That means outer loop is used for representing a data in row wise and inner loop is used for representing a data in column wise. So whatever the logic we have to write, for example, we have to do a addition of two matrix. So we have to write a logic. So logic, we will write the logic inside of inner loop.
Question, can we use else block with loop?
Yes, we can take a else block with loop.
What is the difference between for loop and while loop?
When we have to repeat a code in a sequence for some specified range, then we have to use a for loop. And when we don't know the range, then we have to use a while loop.
Prashant, can you please explain about this string in Python?
String means a sequence of characters are quoted in a double quote or single quote that are called as a string.
How to access character of a string?
There are two ways to access the characters of a string, by indexing or slicing method.
Prashant, how we can access data from a dictionary?
In dictionary, we store a data in key and value pair. So if you want to access a value, so by the help of key, we can access that.
Prashant, what is function? And please explain the types of function in Python.
When we want to access a block of code for a number of times, so what we can do, we can create a single unit and we can put all those code over there. That means a functions. So there are two types of function, predefined function and user defined function. Predefined function, also known as a built-in function, the function which is already available inside a Python and which we are using as per our need and necessity, that is called as predefined function. And user defined function, which we create as per our requirement. Suppose we want to create a login. So as we know that there is no login predefined function are available. So we have to create a login as per our requirement.
How many types of argument we can pass in function?
There are four types of arguments we can pass in function. First is a positional argument. Second one is a default argument. Third one is a keyword argument. And fourth and last one is variable length argument.
Can function return multiple values at a time in Python?
Yeah, sure. In Python, function can return a multiple value at the same time.
Prashant, what is variable? And explain the types of variables in Python.
There are two types of variable, global variable and local variable. The variable which we define inside of scope, inside of function, that is called as a local variable, because that variable having only a scope inside of that scope. And the global variable, which variable we define outside of function, that are called as a global variable. But in Python, there is some feature are also available, like you want to declare any variable inside a function and you want to make that variable as a global variable. So we have a keyword, global keyword. By using a global keyword, we can make that local variable as a global variable. So what will happen exactly? Global variable are accessible throughout any function, throughout any program.
What is recursive function in Python?
The function which call itself again and again, that are called as a recursive function.
Great. So Prashant, tell me, what is anonymous function?
A nameless function are called as an anonymous function and it is also known as a lambda function.
What is the main purpose of the anonymous function?
When we want to execute some code for instant use, that means a one time, so we can go with lambda function.
Great. Can we declare nested function in Python?
Yes, we can declare a nested function. Nested function means a function inside of another function. And in that scenario also, outer function first of all call and then inner function will call.
What is function decorator?
A decorator is also a function and it takes another function as an argument and it extends the functionality of that function. And then it will return that function with additional functionality.
Great. So Prashant, tell me, what is generator?
Generator is also a function and this function we declare as we declare an ordinary function, but instead of return keyword, here we use a yield keyword. And when we have to work with a large number of files, that means there is a large amount of data available, then we have to go with a generator function.